today.
We're going to get started in just a few minutes. If you could see what I see from this vantage point, you would understand, appreciate, and know that if there's anybody that's the architect of the American dream, it is you today.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to protect the American dream? Are you ready to rally? Please welcome your master of ceremonies, Tom Salamone.
Good morning. Let me hear you. Good morning. Welcome to your realtor rally. Simply put, home ownership matters. Let me hear you. Home ownership matters. You know, coming over here today, I was thinking, how many times in our lives do we have an opportunity to be part of history? Our association is 104 years old. Never have we done anything of this magnitude, not to say we're the voice for real estate, but to show we're the voice for real estate. I can't thank you enough, but I want you to turn to the person next to you. I don't care if you hug him, kiss him, shake his hand, but thank him for being here today. I probably shouldn't have said kiss. A couple of people up here are getting out of control. How proud are you to be a realtor? Movisi is a really, really tough boss. I can tell you that. I've known him for over 25 years, and he would say to me, it wasn't loud enough. How proud are you to be a realtor? Is that all right? He says, good. You're the voice for real estate, and we're going to kick things off with an incredible voice, a realtor from Miami, Florida. Cassandra Bissarch will lead us in the national anthem. And I heard you singing all morning, so feel free to sing along with her. Cassandra, a realtor from Miami.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Sandra, let's hear it. And now to lead us in our invocation, our own Erin Campo.
Good morning. What a beautiful sight. Before I lead you in prayer this morning, everyone please join hands with the person next to you. This morning, we pray for those men and women who put themselves in harm's way here and abroad to protect us and our beliefs. We pray for the leaders and lawmakers of the United States of America. We pray for our own, the realtors who work diligently here and across this amazing land, making the America dream a reality. God bless and strengthen all of us. Grant us protection and grace. Give us health of mind and body and perfect love for one another. Give each of us calm, confidence, and strong faith. Dull the edge of our pride, embrace the edge of our humility. In each family, we pray for those that are ill and those who have passed away. Hold them and us in the palm of your hand and bless all of us. Amen.
Thank you, Erin. Now please welcome Tom Davidson, a realtor from right here in Washington, D.C. Tom joined the United States Marine Corps right out of high school and served in a combat role as a reconnaissance Marine. Please welcome Tom.
Realtor rock! Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You know, you're all the realtor leaders across the country. We are very fortunate to have an incredible realtor leader working right up the street in the Capitol for us. And he's our next speaker. I'm going to call up his FPC, my buddy, Neil Jackson from Georgia.
Thank you, Tom. How many federal political coordinators do we have here today? Raise your hand. Boy, looks a great turnout. As many of you know, the federal political coordinators liaison with a specific member of Congress about issues too important to real estate. I wish everybody could be as fortunate as I am to work with Senator Johnny Isaacson. As Tom said, Johnny is not only a friend of realtors, he is one. Senator Isaacson is a third generation realtor. How many realtors in the crowd have a parent, child, or family member that's a realtor? Raise your hand. The families that are realtors together stay together. Coming from a family with generation of realtor service, Senator Isaacson took his knowledge that he learned from his family and put it to work for you and I and our whole country. And let me tell you, it makes a difference when one of our own is at the table. It makes a big difference. One issue after another, he has been at our side. One excellent example of Senator Isaacson's unbending support was his ability to build strong bipartisanship backing for the home buyer tax credit. How many of you sold a home to someone who took advantage of the home buyer tax credit? We have Senator Johnny Isaacson and so many others to thank. I could go on and on, but I'd rather that everyone hear directly from the Senator himself. Please Please welcome fellow realtor, Senator Johnny Isakson from the great state of Georgia.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you, Neil Jackson. Thanks to the realtors of Georgia for being here today. I want to tell you a little secret. 46 years ago this week, in May of 1966, I passed the salesman's license exam in Georgia. And I wrote two checks the next day. One to the Atlanta Board of Realtors for my membership, the other for RPAC to invest in my country. And I haven't missed a year since doing both. Now I want you to pause with me for a minute and think about something. Thousands of realtors gather today on hallowed ground, representing 75 million American homeowners. We stand in the shadow of a monument built to a man who crossed the Atlantic to come to the New World, to hope that he could have a better life for citizens with independence, with freedom, with the right to farm, the right to build, and the right to own. It was George Washington. And with his cohorts, Jefferson, Adams, Madison, Hamilton, Franklin, American history is replete with the importance of the individual ownership and wide distribution of land. Just think about it for a second. When we bought the Louisiana Purchase under the administration of Thomas Jefferson, we surveyed it into land lots and to townships, and we had land rushes to encourage new American citizens to go stake their claim, build their farm, and build their dream, because Americans knew in the 1700s and the 1800s that the strength of our country could be the individual ownership of property and the investment that's made. And every president and every Congress since has done the same thing to encourage home ownership, the wide distribution of the ownership of land, because it's a cornerstone of the freedom of our country and the foundation of the freedom that we all enjoy. Today we come to the Great Mall in the shadow of the monument and in the shadow of the Capitol to talk to the members of Congress about the importance of home ownership and about the three component parts of home ownership that make the United States different than any other country on the face of this earth. One, it's important to our families. It's where they build their memories, build their dreams, build their equity, and provide security for their family. It's important to our communities because it's real estate that pays the ad valorem taxes that finance our schools, our hospitals, finance our law enforcement, and finance our parks, and build security. And it's important to the United States of America. Single-family housing is 15% of the gross domestic product, $2 trillion. And it's that gross domestic product that needs a boost, and it's housing that's the answer from where we are to where we are going to go. We may rally today for an hour or two, but the investment in real estate is worth a lifetime. Now, there's a Capitol not far from us, and at 10 o'clock this morning, the chaplains gave their prayers, the speakers opened the gavel, and Congress is now in session. So I want you to join me in sending them a message. I want to ask you three questions. I want you to answer them, and I'm not going to give you the answers before I ask them either. But when you answer them, I want the Congress of the United States to hear it. I want the President of the United States to hear it. Because we join together not as Democrats or Republicans or Independents. We join together as realtors, representing 75 million homeowners, 15% of gross domestic product, the key difference in our country and every other country on the face of this earth. And we need to send a message and answer three questions. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Is residential real estate and single-family ownership the most important cornerstone of the American economy? Are we ready to go to work and see to it the recovery we're in beginning now will sustain itself to even greater heights?
Yes!
Do we live in the greatest country on the face of this earth?
Yes!
You take that enthusiasm to the halls of Congress.
Yes!
Listen closely to me. Enthusiasm is infectious. Go over to Russell, to Longworth, to Rayburn, and to the Capitol and start an infection. Let's expand home ownership. Let's bring America's economy back. The realtors of America are ready.
For all this man has done for us, there's no way that that was a loud enough thank you. Let me hear it. Let me hear it. I want you to know, nowhere at any time in the world has there been more realtors in one spot. The next person I'm going to bring up really doesn't need any introduction, but I want to tell you something about him anyway. Mo Vesey's been a realtor for over 40 years. I will tell you, he gets up every day and worries about every one of us. He worries about what he can do to make it better for all of our professions. He worries about those 75 million people that Senator Isaacson just spoke about. He has a heart as big as this park. You know, I believe God puts everybody in the right place at the right time. There is absolutely no doubt in my mind that at this time in our association history, we have the right leader working for us. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd ask you to stand because I promised him I'd get him a standing ovation from 10,000 people, and you beat me to it. Please help me welcome the president of the National Association of Realtors, Mo Vesey.
You are the architects of the American dream. I could not be happier. My heart could not be more filled. And the time of day is this time. It's us. The moment is us. Your ability to be able to demonstrate to the people that rule, that set the rules and promulgate the laws and the rules of this country, have got to understand that it's not just an economic engine, that it's not just 330 million people, of which 75 million are homeowners, and those 75 million pay 90% of all the personal federal income tax. It's not the fact that when you sell two houses, you create one job, and even in the worst of times, real estate pumped out over 2.5 million jobs a year. It's not enough to know that when one closing takes place, over $57,000 worth of peripheral activity is generated in appliances and furniture and new roofs and landscaping. Those are the economic engines of the time. Warren Buffett on CNBC 5 weeks ago said, if I had the wherewithal, I would buy 200,000 houses across this country because I think they are better investments long term than even the equities market. But there's something else that you do uniquely and individually every day of your lives. I don't say you're the architects of the American dream for nothing. Every day you put somebody in a home, every day, we know, and you're going to hear statistical evidence, but I'm going to tell you from my heart, I know that those people live longer, they're healthier, their kids are healthier, their marriages last longer. I know their kids make better grades in high school and college and go on to get better jobs. I know there's less teen pregnancy when you have home ownership. I know there's less crime in the community when you have home ownership. I know there's more involvement in communal activities when you have home ownership. And every day of your life, when you put people in a home, you strengthen America. I could not be prouder of the 10,000 people in the park or the million plus people that ply this trade every day. And I'm going to do everything I can to make sure that everything that we believe in, not just our industry, but for the consumer and the customer that you deal with and the homeowner, is practiced at the very highest levels of rulemaking, to make sure that everyone recognizes and understands that home ownership in America is what this country has always been about. You've got in your knapsacks or bags some keys. If you haven't found them, you're going to have to take them out eventually. And this is what I want you to do. Every time you hear something you like, rattle the keys. Every time you think you hear something you like, rattle the keys. And when you go to the expo this afternoon, I want you to take your keys and drop them in the expo bucket at the NAR booth. You see, you meeting here is just the first step. We're going to take those keys by district and go to your congressmen and women. And we're going to say, these people met 10,000 strong to send a message to you. Here are the keys, and there we will dump the keys on their desk. We believe American home ownership must be saved, must be enhanced, must be practiced to make America great. I want to acknowledge before I leave the podium, I'm going to come back and talk to you in a few minutes, that there are congressmen and women all throughout here, but I got these three that just came in. Congressman Billy Long from Missouri. Where are you at, Missouri? By the way, Billy is a realtor. Congressman John Fleshman from Tennessee. Where are you at, Tennessee? And Senator John Hoeven from North Dakota. And another one, Congressman Berg from North Dakota.